So Gary, when we think about Lewden Palazzoli, what springs to your mind?
To my mind, it's the industrial plug and the industrial socket outlet.
You're right, and we have featured them extensively on the channel over the last couple of years. We've even installed one behind us here. We've got our topter there. We'll put in that Wago energy meter. If you haven't seen that video, check it out. And as a result of that, now we've now been able to install an 18 kilowatt fan heater. Yep. And considering today we're in t-shirts on one of the coldest days in December so far, and now that's what a delight that's been. But today we're not looking at plugs and sockets. We will get to one, guy, don't worry.
Okay, good.
We're looking at these light fittings from Lewden Palazzoli.
Okay, and looking at it just from the back, you're looking at it from the front, I would say it oozes absolute quality.
Yeah, it absolutely is. It's quality and flexibility. I'd probably best sum these up as the Swiss Army knives of industrial lighting, because pretty much between the two products we've got here, you can cover almost every industrial lighting application there. But you're right, quality. How do we know about the quality though, Gary?
We'd know about it from just simple things like the bracket on the back. So when I take it out, I've got the stainless steel bolts, and I can fix that bracket in several different positions depending on what I want to use it for. Mm-hmm. So application wise, these can be mounted in different ways. And when I think about mounting it, I have to think back about that lighting designer. And what have they suggested I need to do in order to get the correct light pattern in that area? And then you've got an angled gauge on the side engraved, so you can actually set it perfectly as well.
Yeah, and that's just one of the things that quality, but also think about quality. Lots of people talk about form and function of the products, but we've actually seen these products being made from start to finish. Now, we will put a link in the description to the video where we trace this through at the Lewden Palazzoli factory, and you'll see the processes and the care and attention that goes into assemble what we'd call is a quality product. And again, lots of people talk about quality, but it's that dependability in some very heavy industrial applications where the design features in this product really come out.
Yeah, and it was wonderful, wasn't it? That raw material to end, actually to be involved in that process was an amazing thing. And what I liked about it, when you got to the very end and they tested it, you got a smiley face and you got a sticker. It felt like I was back at the dentist.
Yeah, so we've got two products from the range here. We've got the Tigua, when this version here has been configured as a floodlight with a bracket so you can mount it on the wall.
Right.
And we've got the Meta, which is a high bay light, but again, this has been configured as a wall mountable high bay. Now, we don't normally assume high bays being wall mountable. We normally think they're hanging suspended from the roof.
We do, yeah.
But you're right, you've got that adjustable wall bracket you just mentioned, Gary. But that is the start. So this range here goes from, depending on lumen packages, from 4,000 lumens to over 27,000 lumens. Or as you would know that, Gary, what's that?
Broad daylight.
Yeah, it's certainly a lot of light. And obviously, dependent on mounting heights, so we can talk about this. Sometimes this can be configured as a low bay and then a high bay, but obviously where you use them obviously depends on the exact configuration of a factory or a space. Or you can even configure this as a floodlighting option.
Yeah.
And to go with that, there are mounting poles. You can mount it on a pole, on the top of a pole. There's other options, wire guards, and you know, then think about those other materials. So this one here has got glass. But what's the other option, Gary?
Yeah, you can have plastic as well. If you think you're maybe in a food processing environment, you probably wouldn't want a glass lens in that environment in case for some reason it happened to shatter and obviously came down.
Yeah, so there is a specific approval for that if you're working in the food industry. Yeah, you don't want glass shattering, and that can cause the shutdown of an entire factory.
It can.
So other options, we can have these in emergency versions as well.
Yeah, we can also have them in the one that we're going to cover soon on the channel. We can have it in DALI as well. We've been asked and requested it, and we can do a DALI connection as well.
And that comes down. So speaking of connections, Gary, I knew you'd get back the connections. Is that safe territory for you?
It is safe territory for me, but of course, with the minute we mentioned connections, yeah, I noticed the ferrules are out, and you're in making those connections into this adapter here in order that we can make that connection. So, of course, we love a ferruled end. There's more connections now because we've got the DALI. Just talk me through those connections.
Yeah, so the DALI has an additional two connections, a plus and minus, for the DALI bus. Now, every time we mention DALI, people always say, will you do more on DALI? And the good news is, in the new year, we will be doing some videos specifically about DALI to help people understand the lighting control system that is DALI, not the surrealist painter. So from that, but then think of this in this application. So in DALI here, this would probably be installed in a factory environment. Yeah. You can then couple that to occupancy sensors, so you can turn down the lights when there's nobody in the space. but then also think about daylight coming in through possibly windows or doors. You can have constant light level and the lights will adjust accordingly, and that adds to energy savings but also the long-term lumen maintenance of these products.
Yeah, it's really good. And that plug that goes in there, okay, as we push it in, I absolutely love it because it goes in and it locks itself into the on position. In order to release it, you have to go in and give it a twist and take it back out. Again, that's brilliant design, and that's where it oozes quality once again.
Yeah, and a lot of those features, unfortunately, are all hidden under the cover. You get a little peep on this one. If you look through the window where it says Palazzoil, you can see what's going on in there. But these are designed as sealed products, so you don't have to, when you get the site, remove covers, that plug, you know, you wouldn't necessarily want to be trying to balance that and connect wires into it at the time. So that plug and socket is, yeah, it's fantastic for that. You're right, oozes quality, Gary.
Yeah, it's also got a little thing down here. Okay, I'm really interested. Can you just explain to me again what that is?
Have you got a waterproof coat, Gary?
I have got a waterproof coat.
Yeah, have you heard of Gore-Tex?
I have heard of Gore-Tex, yes.
So this is what's known as a Gore vent, and it uses the same material that's on a waterproof coat. So it's a breathable membrane. Okay. So what that does is, obviously, when things get hot, the air inside them expands, and that causes a pressure difference, and this manages that pressure difference. So that air can go in and out, so it doesn't stress the gasket seals, and you can keep that high IP66 and 67 rating of these products.
Okay, when it comes down to quality, I think then optics, because that's really where we're going to see the benefit of a quality light fitting. Talk me through the optics, Gordon.
Yeah, so I mean, I'll flip this version over and you'll see, yeah, there are some very different optics to what you used to see on a lot of high bays that you see possibly off the shelf.
Right.
And obviously by tailoring the light, you can use less fittings and use them in different applications. So this is a high bay light, but it's configured to be mounted on the wall.
Right.
So when we do that, that means we want to push the light forward from the wall, not back behind the wall, and we want to spread it out at an even angle to achieve the maximum spacing between fittings.
Yes.
However, that comes with that, obviously, in a factory environment, you've got to think, people obviously trying to work.
They are, yeah.
So you've got to minimize things like glare. And so the optics play a part in that. So glare is often something people say, oh, this fitting is low glare. It can be because it's got great optics, but that actually has to be designed in the application, because obviously it depends on where you put that. If you say, you know, working on a bench like this, but in the corner of your eye, that you've got this glare, this really bright light fitting, that obviously causes all sorts of problems.
So when we turn them on and we see them there facing the wall, we can see that no light is coming back to where the camera is. The light is being thrown forward, but then because of the optics and how they're obviously designed, we're actually getting light either thrown straight down, and then when we rotate that light fitting round, we can see that that light now is not being thrown down, it's being thrown up, but it's never being thrown back beyond the light fitting, is it?
Yeah, that's it. And obviously in an outdoor environment, say you're using this as a floodlight, obviously this can be configured as a floodlight, you're not getting that upward light as well, and upward light means light pollution.
Oh, right, okay, yeah, that makes sense. And exactly the same, when we brought that one into the wall, the floodlight in there, we got exactly the same process, and we rotated it around in the same order. We could see that we were throwing light down, and obviously we flip it around, we were throwing light up. But again, we weren't throwing any light back towards where the camera was.
Yeah, and that's the optics we've got here. But if you look again, I'll put a link in the description to the data sheets for these products. There's an extensive range of optical solutions. You can get a narrow beam version, which can be good for a floodlighting, or if you're in an environment where the high bay itself is at an incredibly high ceiling height and you don't necessarily need to spread it, you need a good amount of light coming straight down from the fitting.
It's quality. It's absolute quality from Lewden Palazzoli. It's what we expect. It's what we're seeing in their plugs and sockets. We've taken it to a different level with these high bay lights.
And obviously, so we are, as we said, going to look at that DALI. I think if there's any other questions about lighting, the other one we get as often the well comes up as emergency lighting.
Yeah.
Let me know. These also are available with emergency lighting packs as well. We'll try and answer those as well. But put your comments in. Are you working in any heavy industrial environments that could benefit from something like this? Or have you got any other questions related to lighting? And Gary will try and get back to as many as he can.
Only if you put the heater back on, because the temperature's dropped in here, Gordon.